Let's see. What will I learn about today? Huh? Drain? The kitchen drain? This must be a mistake. I need to call Energy Friend. Hello, Energy Friend.
Cosmo, what are we learning about today? Gravity, electricity, I know, explosions.
The kitchen sink.
What?
I know. Let's conduct an experiment. What if we got a bunch of liquids and pour them down the kitchen sink and see what happens?
That's the exact opposite of what I've been told to do, so start the simulation.
Hee-hee.
How about liquids with safety symbols? I was told that they should never go down the drain.
This grease is a liquid, but that's because it's, ouch, hot. When grease cools down, it changes state and transforms from a liquid into a solid. If you poured hot grease down the drain, the grease would coat the inside of the pipe as it cooled. Grease is sticky and would catch any hairs or food crumbs going down the drain. This would form a clog, and the drain would stop working.
Ugh. Yuck, yuck, yuck!
This huge buildup of grease is called a fatberg, like an iceberg. In 2017, sewer workers in London, England found a fatberg that was 209 feet long. That's the length of two blue whales. The fatberg clogged up the entire sewage system and took weeks to remove. If you live in a town or city, any liquid that you dump down the drain travels to the sewage treatment plant. At the sewage treatment plant, chemicals are added to the water to kill most of the germs. This water is then released back into rivers, lakes, or the ocean.
And what if I dumped my cough syrup down the drain?
Well, let's find out. Most sewage treatment plants can't remove medicines from water. This means that if you poured medicine down the drain, the medicine would also end up in lakes, rivers, and oceans. Scientists did experiments and found that when minnows were living in water polluted with human medications, the minnows didn't grow as large and had difficulty escaping from predators. Yikes!
How about liquids with safety symbols? I was told that they should never go down the drain.
This symbol means corrosive. If you pour corrosive liquids like oven cleaner or battery acid down the drain, they destroy whatever they touch, including the pipes in your house. Whoops! This symbol's easy. Flammable liquids are easily set on fire. If you pour gasoline or nail polish remover down the drain, a single spark might cause them to catch on fire or even explode. Look out! Yikes! This symbol tells you that liquids like pesticides and paint are poisonous. If you pour toxic liquids down the drain, they would poison plants and animals when the water is released back into the environment.
Aha! Now I know why there are so many drain rules. Please end the simulation before anyone sees what I did to the kitchen.
So, what should be done with these liquids?
It's pretty easy. Cold grease goes in the garbage, old medications go back to the drugstore, and any dangerous liquids go to your local garbage dump.
I guess the kitchen sink did have something to teach us. Bye!
Bye, Cosmo.
Which chapter should I research next?
Cosmo!
Hey everyone, Cosmo here. Many household cleaners should not be poured down the drain. But what if you could make a safe and simple cleaner with ingredients you probably have in your kitchen? Step 1, find an adult. Step 2, go to the kitchen and find some white vinegar and a clean, empty spray bottle. Open the spray bottle and add 1 cup of water with 1 cup of vinegar. Step 3, add something to make it smell nice, like lemon or orange peel. Step 4, put the lid on the spray bottle and give the mixture a good shake. Make a label for your bottle. Does your cleaner have a special name? Step 5, spray your cleaner on glass, the floor, the bathroom, and even the dishes. Rinse well and wipe dry. Cleaning has never been so scientific. I'll see you next time on What If Kids? Goodbye!